Now, visually, the map is stunning, and it holds up very well. Treyarch's attention to detail in World at War does not get enough credit, and it's on full display with this map. Looking back, it seems like every single map in Call of Duty has some kind of insight from the COD community. From me, from you guys, and COD players are an extremely passionate bunch of people, and they remember everything, anything, and everything from the series. Good, bad, ugly, it doesn't matter. With that being said, I bet I'm gonna play a little game here. I think I can stump some of you with this video today. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to the COD History Series. Today, we're gonna be checking out 10 maps in COD history that nobody remembers. And Circle of Trust, you can be honest, if I put one up on the screen and you say, wow, I actually forgot about that, you let me know in the comment section. And let me know another map that doesn't make the list that you don't think anybody can remember. See if you can stump the COD community as well. Drop a like, and let's kick things off with Hotel in Black Ops 1. Now, you can't say, oh, Jimmy, after I say the name of the map, and then you're like, yeah, I remember it. You're supposed to go with, oh, wow, yeah, I forgot about Hotel, but now I remember it. Now, you're gonna see a decent amount of Black Ops 1 maps on this list because Black Ops 1 had the most DLC maps of any COD game of its time. So naturally, there was plenty of people who got left behind, and there were tons of maps that got left in the dust. The first of these forgotten maps is Hotel, which was released as part of the Escalation DLC pack. It was set at a large hotel in Cuba. Now, this map was pretty big. It had a ton of long sightlines, which made for a lot of intense sniper duels and some sneaky flanks. There was even elevators, which was cool. The map was also very beautiful. It featured some awesome landscapes, and the fact that it was a fancy hotel in the 1960s gave Treyarch the opportunity to really go in with that 60s vibe that a lot of people enjoy. Black Ops 1 has a ton of awesome DLC maps, but Hotel often falls through the cracks, so it's my number 10 spot today. Next up, and for some reason, I'm attached to this map. I don't know why. I'm trying to put my finger on it. Discovery in Black Ops 1. Another awesome visual style map, and it's a shame that not many people remember it. It was set on a frozen German outpost in Antarctica, similar to the one that you go to during the campaign in Project Nova. The layout, it kind of reminds me of a mix between Summit and Array, with the snowy environment and the mix between the indoor and outdoor areas that kind of blends close and mid-range combat together. Now the map, it had some interactive elements, I think. I think there was a big ice bridge in the middle, and if you had enough firepower, you could actually knock that bridge down. But people mainly stuck to either rusting with SMGs or staying back with snipers on the map, and it made for some very interesting objective matches. Domination matches on this map were intense. It's a good pick. I wish more people remembered it. Would you guys like to see more interactive elements be brought back into COD? Black Ops 1 had quite a bit of maps where you could actually alter the battlefield a little bit by doing certain things, but after BO1, COD kind of started walking away from that concept. Now, I don't care what you say, half of you are not going to remember this map. Creek in COD 4. Now, COD 4 only had a handful of DLC maps, and people remember most of them, except for Creek. Four DLC maps, that's what COD 4's offering was. You had Chinatown, Kill House, Broadcast, but then there was the fourth that nobody can recall until I say it, Creek. It was the biggest map in COD 4, which explains why nobody liked it. And it's kind of like Overgrown, but it was even bigger, and it was even more open, if you can believe that. Visually, it was a really cool looking map, and the remastered version was absolutely gorgeous, even if it was kind of dumb that Activision charged for it for the second time, but that's neither here nor there. Due to it being a DLC map in COD 4, as well as not exactly being a great time to play on, hardly anybody remembers it. They push it to the back. I know, some people remember it exists, but nobody actually remembers the layout of the map itself, and there it is. Creek in COD 4, not a name you hear very often. How about Salvage in Modern Warfare 2? This was one of those DLC maps in Modern Warfare 2 that faded into obscurity. I mean, it looked quite a bit like some of the other Modern Warfare 2 maps out. I mean, let's be real here. Modern Warfare 2 had some really good map design, but a lot of them kind of shared the same visual style, which made them less extravagant, and they kind of blended together. Regardless, Salvage was a snowy map set in a junkyard in Russia. It made for a pretty awesome backdrop to any Call of Duty match. There was a lot of tight corridors, as well as long sight lines, and while it did kind of feel like derail and sub-base put together, it was still unique enough in its own layout to be fun. It's just a shame nobody really remembers it, but I think we can all agree that it wasn't one of the upper tier DLC maps in Modern Warfare 2, so I guess it kind of makes sense and I'll give everybody a pass. At number 6, Battery in World at War. World at War, it had a ton of underrated maps, both in the base game and as DLC. Battery was released in the third map pack for World at War, and it was a close quarters map that was designed to allow every single playstyle to be viable. It pulled it off, I think. It was set in the Fort Drum in the Philippines, and it's a shame it was released so late in the game's lifespan and so close to the launch of Modern Warfare 2 because nobody remembers it. It was fun. It allowed for some really diverse engagements. You had mid-range, close-range, and some areas with longer sight lines for the sniper. The map had it all. It did. It was a complete package. I wish it would make a comeback in the future, but I don't know. It got buried. At number 5, and what comes to mind here for me is an Easter egg. We won't go into that, though. Liberation in Modern Warfare 3, another game that had a ton of DLC maps, but the structure was pretty different from what we were used to. Back in Modern Warfare 3, if you bought the season pass, there was a much more steady drip of content than the normal DLC system of 4 big dropouts throughout the year. It wasn't a drip like the Modern Warfare like this now. It was actually a content drip that kept you excited for what was to come because the content was frequent and it was good. But anyway, Liberation was a pretty decently sized map with a very interesting layout. It made use of bridges, underpasses, tunnels, secret passageways, all kinds of ways to get from point to point. It was a good map. And of all the Modern Warfare 3 maps, this was probably one of the least remembered ones out of the entire group. Here's another one I bet none of you remember. Station in World at War. Now, this is one of the coolest multiplayer maps in COD history if you're going in terms of theming and visual style. And for that, it is a freaking shame that nobody remembers it. But to be fair, most people don't remember any of the DLC maps from World at War because this was back before COD was a huge blockbuster. Not a whole lot of people actually bought DLC maps, but I digress. Station launched in February of 2009. Medium-sized map set in a Berlin train station that borrowed a lot of elements from the campaign mission Eviction. Now, visually, the map is stunning, and it holds up very well. Treyarch's attention to detail in World at War does not get enough credit, and it's on full display with this map. And plus, it was fun to play. It was. There was little passageways to get around. It kind of felt like a Modern Warfare 3 map, but a bit faster paced and with much, much more interesting themes. At number 3, Storm in Modern Warfare 2. Super interesting map, kind of acting like a blend of Vacant from COD 4 and Overpass from Modern Warfare 2, all with a rainy background to add to that immersion. Now, it was added to the game as part of the Stimulus Package DLC. It was a medium-large map with a 3-lane design where the 2 outside lanes were outdoors, but the middle lane was throughout a mechanical warehouse, complete with tons of little rooms, nooks, and crannies for you to explore and use to your advantage. Map knowledge was key here. New players, they would get stomped on for just running into battle, while the experienced players knew all the little secret spaces and they could easily drop nuke after nuke. There are also a ton of fun little cosmetic details on this map. You had mannequins, you had paintings of ghosts, which just added to the darker atmosphere and it helped the immersion. But due to it being a DLC map and kind of a slower paced one at that, Storm was never really a standout with Modern Warfare 2 players, but I thought it was worth putting on here because it's a fun one to play, even if it wasn't quite as action-packed as the main Modern Warfare 2 standouts. At number 2, Kowloon in Black Ops 1. One more Black Ops map. Another DLC map. This time, we're at night, we're set in Hong Kong, and it got a bit of attention from the community for its use of zip lines. That's right, this was the first time Call of Duty had zip lines. The layout, it was roughly based on the city portion of the campaign mission Numbers, and traversing it on foot was a bit of a pain, but you had zips. There was a lot of alleyways you could hide in and run around, but if you were going for it, you could use a zip line, which would leave you completely exposed, but it would also let you get to various objectives way, way faster. It did. Like I said before, Black Ops 1 really wanted to make use of interactive elements on their multiplayer maps, which is a system that COD doesn't do as much now. We saw a little bit of it in Ghost, but again, it never really caught on. And personally, I think Black Ops 1 did interactiveness way better than Ghost did, but either way, I think it would be cool to see another COD game experiment a little more with it if it was done right. Maybe add a new layer of flavor to Call of Duty's multiplayer. And at number 1 today, U-Turn. U with a dash, turn. Modern Warfare 3. DLC map that probably had the weirdest layout of any map on this list, and perhaps the weirdest layout of any map in COD history. Rather than being 3 lanes or an open battlefield or anything like that, it was a weird 4-lane map with a couple connecting pathways, which was, it made for this weird and chaotic experience. The map was set on a destroyed road in the Middle East. had a whole bunch of busted up cars and tanks acting as your cover pieces, but since you were on the road, well, there was no overhead cover. So if someone got a Predator or an AC-130, the multi-kills, well, they were coming in hot. It's one of those maps that nobody remembers, even if you were an avid Modern Warfare 3 player, and that's kind of interesting because Modern Warfare 3 is such a fan favorite, and this map was so unique, and for that, I mean, I have to give it the number one spot. It was super unique, but it wasn't remembered. You guys let me know one map that deserves to be remembered. Put it in the comment section today. Make sure you guys follow me on Twitter, and I'll see you soon.